This is DDT. In the 40s, 50s, and 60s, it was considered as the safest pesticide, so safe that it used to be sprayed on people. But in 1972, it was banned. It proved to be an environmental horror. What actually went wrong with the safest pesticide? Why was it banned? And is DDT still in our environment?
An environmental tragedy. It's been unfolding for generations.
Exposure to the DDT may increase elderly people's risk of Alzheimer's disease.
Now, of course, we know that what they were spraying was the evil DDT.
Unless we do bring these chemicals under better control, we are certainly headed for disaster.
In a laboratory deep within the confines of Basel, Switzerland, during the turbulent times of the late 1930s, a scientist named Dr. Paul Hermann Muller stumbled upon a chemical that would reshape the world of agriculture. This chemical was dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane, better known by its abbreviation, DDT. Dr. Muller wasn't looking for a pesticide. His journey began in the realm of moth-proofing agents. But as serendipity would have it, he discovered that DDT was not only an excellent insect repellent, but also a highly effective insecticide. Recognizing the potential of his discovery, Muller tested it against several insects and found it to be extraordinarily lethal. World War II soon raged, and DDT found itself front and center in the battle against disease-carrying pests. Soldiers, children, and whole towns were dusted with DDT to combat malaria-carrying mosquitoes and typhus-bearing lice. Malaria rates plummeted. DDT seemed a miracle chemical, and Muller was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1948 for its discovery. But as with many tales of wonder, there lurked a darker side. While DDT was indeed effective against pests, it did not decompose quickly. Instead, it lingered in the environment, accumulating in the fatty tissues of animals. As one creature ate another, DDT magnified up the food chain. Birds of prey, like the peregrine falcon and the bald eagle, were hit especially hard. Their eggshells thinned, leading to breakages and a decline in their populations. Beyond this, DDT had other relatives. DDD and DDE both are breakdown products of DDT, and they share its persistent nature. While DDT was also used as a pesticide, DDE primarily formed as DDT degraded. These compounds, like DDT, accumulated in the environment and magnified through food chains. By the 1960s, the effects on wildlife could no longer be ignored. Furthermore, concerns about potential human health impacts began to emerge. DDT and its metabolites were linked to a range of potential health effects in humans, from cancer to reproductive issues. In 1962, marine biologist Rachel Carson published Silent Spring, a groundbreaking book that chronicled the environmental impacts of pesticides, with DDT at its center. Carson's meticulous research and passionate prose brought attention to the perilous side of DDT. The book sparked a global environmental movement and led to increased scrutiny of chemical pesticides. Following mounting evidence of its environmental and potential human health impacts, DDT was banned for agricultural use in the United States in 1972. Many other countries followed suit, either banning or severely restricting its use. Today, the use of DDT is limited globally. The Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants, which came into effect in 2004, allows the use of DDT in certain cases to control malaria, but its production and use are otherwise banned or restricted in many countries. However, the legacy of DDT and its kin lingers on. Residues can still be found in soils, waters, and even some animals. If DDT, DDE, or DDD have ever been sprayed or detected in your area, there is a good chance that these chemicals are still in your groundwater and are still accumulated in the food chain of the animals living in your area. Drops of Balance has been scientifically proven to remediate these chemicals by over 80% within 48 hours in water at a concentration of 1 teaspoon per gallon. Check out our safety and testing tab to learn more about all the other chemicals Drops of Balance can remediate from your water source. Link is in the description. And if you use my code SAFECLEANWATER, you'll get an extra 10% off.